priest gave him the diary.
Mm-hmm.
And I still see him with the diary, with the papers under his arm, seeing my parents. He was, of course, overjoyed that we were still in the same apartment where he had last seen us. There were so few of us left, you know. So here we are old friends, and he talked with my parents and asked them what they think would be something to publish. Some people had said that he should publish it, and others said, no, let bygones be bygones. And I mean, there were a lot of talk. So that's when I saw him. Another more traumatic event was that when he still believed, Otto Frank still believed that Margot and Anne had survived, he would go to the station. They were, the railroad service had not resumed yet, but they were trains coming from Germany, from the east, we called it, with straggling survivors. And so Otto Frank and my husband, who was hoping that his mother had survived the Bergen-Belsen because she was on the list of liberated people, so the two men would go to the station together. And Mr. Frank had two pictures of Margot and Anne, and my husband had a picture of his mother, and asked the psychiatrist, did you see these girls, did you see this woman, and so on. So the two men sort of bonded over that harrowing experience. And that's why he was my husband's best man at the wedding later on.
Mm.